would be really a very, very considerable upset if Bott was to lose this one. Eckhart Dagger there just behind him, giving him the final little words of encouragement. You can see the bandage on his left knee. 8 rounds.
Again, yeah. Put a bit of respect into Bottner. That's another superb right hand.
Yes, and a little sort of shiver of anticipation goes through the crowd. Don't want to see this happening to the local boy.
And now Marcus knows what it's like to fight a legitimate heavyweight. Already he's marked and swollen a little bit around the left eye.
Rick.
What Murray's got to do is start using that big long jab that he has, banging it into Bott's chest, and pop that right hand over every now and again, because he will have stunned Bott, and already he looks a bit shaky around the legs, but...
He's got it! And Murray is doing a job on the German champion.
Look at his legs, Dave. They're gone already.
Murray, very shaky, impassive. Right hand, and so nearly had him. And Bott is looking anything but a heavyweight champion at the moment.
This could be a major upset here.
This will be a major upset. Bott trying to come back.
Well, at last starting to throw punches. Well, he's badly shaken. He looks glassy around the eyes, and his legs are shaking. Murray's just got to wait for him to come at him and bomb that big right hand over the top.
The crowd trying to get behind Bott. This is a courageous fight back by the German heavyweight champion, but you wonder whether he can keep this going for 8 rounds, because these big clubbing right hands from Murray have so nearly had him down.
When someone that size hits you, Dave, it's a tremendous shock to your system. I think Marcus is finding that out. And you see, his punches are not having the effect it would have on a cruiserweight. And Murray's just got to tuck up here and keep bombing that right hand over. Pretty sure the left hook is kind of stopping after the right hand. And, you know, this could be a big upset. And certainly he shook up the Bott in that round. And that was, in my opinion, his round. Right hand, he almost touched down Bott, right uppercut in the left hook, and this was sort of the one where he almost clubbed him to the floor. That was near the end of the round. If we see the earlier one, he really hit him with a nice clean right hand just around the side of the head in the temple area, and had him in big trouble. This is maybe it here. Bang,
that was the one.
Almost touched down.
That was the one. We nearly had touched
knee
down
of Bott almost gave out on him there.
Round two coming up.
He still won't have shaken the cobwebs out. And if Murray can be quick enough to follow up on that, he could stop Bott.
You know, Michael Murray's manager, a canny character by the name of Jack Trickett, and who was here, incidentally, in Hamburg for this fight. And I just wonder whether he's pulled a fast one over the Marcus Bott camp.
He's not called Jack Tricky Trickett for nothing. He's matched this fighter very well here, and this could be a major upset. You know, and And Michael Murray has been sparring down in the Matchwood gym and getting himself into good shape. And it shows because although Marcus is lighter and quicker, he's able to hit him with that right hand and the left hook. Dag in the corner looking very apprehensive indeed. Sitting on the ring apron, which in England he wouldn't be allowed to do.
And Pot getting very marked up under the left eye now. Trying to take the fight to Murray. Gets him a good right hand.
That's what he's got to do, Dave. He's got to pepper him. He's got to punch him all over the place. And you know, when Michael stops punching, he's got to start and work his body and work his, you know, stay close to him and not hang himself out there and get nailed with that right hand like he's been doing.
Well, you can see Eckhart Dagger, who should not be sitting on the ring apron there. The referee should tell him to kindly go and sit somewhere else. That is, well, one in row. Getting away with it. If you can get away with it, then do it. And, well, referee Norbert Rausch is having a word about holding. I'm not aware that Murray's holding. Let's go.
And that's what Murray's got to do. Stop him when he gets in close. Tie him up and, you know, bang him as he's walking in there. Keep popping that. He's got to get that right hand off a bit sooner. And as butt rocks forward, boom. And follow up with the left hook and then tie him up when he gets too close. That's where the smaller man can do his work on the inside. Looks very cool and very relaxed, Michael Murray, but he's certainly surprised by this one. He's got another one of those right hands. Every single one of those punches are shaking him to his boots.
And they're hurting, and he's not covering up very well.
And even when he is there, they'll get him through. Can't keep taking these right hands like that. They're just bouncing off his head. And look at how red his face is in the corner there. I can tell you, Eckhart Dagg is a very worried man.
And he's saying to himself, what did I leave Cruiserweight for? Well, only he knows the answer to that. Only lost one fight, Johnny Nelson, remember? And he's beaten some reasonable fighters as well. Some good names on his record: Yves Monsieur, Johnny Held, Manfred Yassman. And it's not as if the German rusty at all. He was in action only on the 16th of last month when he knocked out Eddie Curry in a round.
Bot's left eye is beginning to really swell up, and if he keeps taking those right hands, it won't be long before it's actually closed, and he won't be able to see that right hand at all.
That's right. Scheduled for 8 rounds, this, remember.
He needs to get to work on Murray, and he needs to do it. He needs to hurt him and work him over. He hasn't been doing that up to now.
Remember that Murray has only been stopped once. But renowned as a puncher.
The clubbing right hand is really hurting, but Murray's doing everything right here. He's tying him up when he gets in close and keeping the fight at long range. And it's hard to lug a big guy like that around for Bot. It must be, you know, hit him at the back of the head. Well, that was good refereeing there. I don't think he meant to hit him. He just lobbed that right hand and happened to hit him on the side. He's shaking this guy, Dave, every time
every time he hits him. The ring canvas is wrinkling. That must be quite difficult to get a hold out there.
Sounded good. Didn't do anything to Murray.
No.
Oh, that right hand. This is the beginning of the end for this kid. He's really, he's in trouble. He's in big trouble.
Murray's got to step back. Well, you've got to say this for Buck. He can take a shot and he's coming back.
He's taking a lot of the right hand there.
This is one good fight. This is.
Certainly. Probably getting the money's worth here. You know, Murray haven't had no amateur experience of boxing very well here. He's beginning to work the body there as well. Chopping right hands over the top. That left hook's coming up and he's just doing everything right. Slicing this guy to pieces.
Buck trying to get inside work to the body. And the left eye is, as Barry has said, is getting just a little bit slitty. Cheek swelling up.
The only worry with Murray is that he may run out of steam because, you know, this is a lighter man. He's putting pressure on him. And Butler's come into it a bit more in this round. Stopped a couple of good right hands, but he's starting to put pressure on Murray now. And Murray, is he beginning to slow down? Those right hands are really, really hurting, but.
Last 10.
He must have stopped 50 of them so far.
We're going to take a break from this enthralling heavyweight contest. We'll be back for the start of round 4 in just a moment or two. Have a word, I said he was manager Eckhart Dagger after this. What are you doing to me, boss?
He could have picked an easier one.
Yeah, exactly. Round 4.
Another right hand from Murray. This shows you the way he can throw him around. He's just like a little lightweight to me. Marcus has got to start throwing punches and throw more than one and two. He's just got to pepper him all over the body and then tuck up when he gets on the outside. If Murray makes a concerted effort here and just really pushes him back and hits him with some good punches, he could stop him.
Well, yes, we've been talking about Murray perhaps getting tired. We don't know how much we don't know how much that Boxleff got left in the tank.
Yeah, well, got in real trouble in the last round there, and then he can roll him back to the finish.
Crowd getting behind the local man.
He hasn't taken anything at all from bodies. He's covering up, taking a couple of good shots around the body, but not taking much to the head, and Bot hasn't hurt him at any time. There's another one of those right hands on the side. You know what, you've got to say to yourself, how many of those right hands can he take? That sweep and left hook could have taken his head off there, only got his head out of the way. Murray's throwing those punches with bad intentions.
Yeah, bad attitude. Well, this is the sort of fight that gives boxing its romance. I know the sport's got its critics, of course it has, but when you've got a boy like Murray who can come from nowhere and take on the number 6 rated heavyweight in Europe and be in with a chance of beating him, who can deny him that right?
Oh, an uppercut right hand. There's 3 right hands in a row there from Murray. Oh, good right up. That's the one punch that he's hurt Murray with. That was a good chopping right uppercut. Landed. Taking far too many punches, Marcus. Look at that left hand. another one of those right hands, and really beginning to puff up and close.
Last 10.
There's a two good solid body punch. Now they'll have hurt Murray, for sure.
Well, you start wondering to yourself if this goes 8 rounds.
Left hand, and chopping right. Now that Landstorff bought shoulders, so that saved him from taking another solid right. But that's the one where the referee warned him, I think, for chopping around the back of the head. But Murray's boxing very well.
Round 5. Remember, 14 stone. Oh, Murray 16 stone, and making every pound of that advantage count.
I tell you what, Michael Murray is picking the shots very well here. This is an impressive performance. Now, I'll bet you when he looks at this on video afterwards, he'll see that the way he's improving as a fighter. This is a bad move for Marcus Spott to pick this guy.
Good round this for Murray so far.
Well, again, you see Potts coming forward, but Murray's landing the cleaner punches.
And he's looking really banged up now, the German heavyweight champion.
Murray getting up on his feet now.
Oh, yes.
What a right hand.
And for once, it's Bott who's forced to hold on. Referee tells him not to.
Oh, right hand left hand.
Oh, Murray has got him very close to going, but the German has got incredible depths of courage and stamina. Keeps coming back, and Murray impassive. This is a good round for the Manchester boy.
But takes a shot and a half. Okay, those are really solid punches.
He does. He certainly does, Barry. Now Murray must not get discouraged that these big bombs are not putting his opponent away. Referee's trapped in the corner. Oh.
That
the left hook.
Another right hand.
He's right above us.
Referee's stopping this.
He's right above us.
Oh, he's giving
him a standing
count.
Murray thought he'd won it.
Yeah, he needed that count.
Murray thought he'd won it. Well, that's a good fortune for Marcus Bott. I feel sure that fight would have been stopped in Great Britain.
Yeah, he looked badly hurt there, but he's coming roaring back. It's just typical how tough the kid is. He's a real strong guy, and that's why he's fought for a European title.
Murray's got him again. They are right above us. Right above us, and this is a dreadful round for Marcus Bott.
15 seconds to go, and Bott is in all sorts of trouble. Murray, I've always said, if he'd made a concerted effort there, really put his punches together, he would have Bott in big trouble.
Well, this was a big, big round for Michael Murray. That's got to be a 10-8 round, that.
Ask yourself, how much energy did Murray expend there? Oh, that's that right hand. Oh. God, this Marcus Bott can take a punch.
Well, some of these shots, really.
Can't keep taking them, but... Oh, look at that left hook. That would have put the normal man's head into the third row. He makes a concerted effort. If he puts those combinations together with a bit of consistency and pushes Bott back, this fight could be over. Bott can box in the retreat. He has to come forward. Every time Murray pushes him back, look at the trouble that he has in it.
Yeah.
strong referee.
No, I do not agree with that, I'm afraid. Referee Crosh.
This is where a hometown referee can help his fighter, give him little breaks. And
this
and
is, I think this round
for 1 minute
is going to get
him, but this is what can happen. And here's this effort again from Murray. He put in more of those and pushed Bud back. Ooh!
If one of those connects, if just one of those connects.
Well, a lot of them have connected so far. He's still there. That is just getting worn down here. Well, he's starting to blow a bit himself, and you can understand why.
Well, I tell you, win, lose or draw, Marcus Pott would be very ill advised to continue going on as a heavyweight.
He's not big enough. There's obviously more money in the heavyweight division. The cruiserweight is a bit of a nothing title. There's another left hook. Oh, God, this fella's hurt again.
Murray's looking a little bit tired now.
Doesn't look for it, just looks tired.
Yes. And Bot senses that, I think. Tries to pour it on. But it's an awful job. Levering a man of 16 stone around the ring. That's Bot's round.
Yeah. Good finish for him. Very close round, but he'll get it because he finished better. Murray's expended a lot of energy in those early rounds trying to stop, but you know, you wonder how much he's got left.
Well, there's the blue corner, and there's Marcus Pott, who is he's taken an awful lot of punishment. Two left.
Right up with him here. Watch this.
Oh.
Good punch.
Well, I tell you, when we come to our Pro Box Awards in July of next year, you can pencil this one in as one of the fights of the year. Drags himself off his stool. The crowd getting behind him. Cries of Marcus, Marcus.
Bot's got to pull it all out here to win this fight. He's got to pour in with those punches in the next two rounds. Just pepper Michael Murray. Now, I don't think he should try to stop him. Just throw loads of punches at his body and you know, switch his angles and use his speed because he's always badly hurt here again. This is Murray again, right hand. Oh, this guy's in trouble.
He's got him going again.
Oh, he's in big trouble here. Badly shaken.
Another standing count. And the manager up in the corner, which is absolutely absurd. Absolutely absurd.
Murray puts in a real effort here. He could stop by Bot badly. Look at the squinting in the eyes.
It's a second standing count. He's got him. He should stop this.
Oh. Our referee should stop this. This kid's in trouble.
I don't believe this. This is dreadful refereeing. This is absolutely dreadful refereeing. If the German referee does not stop this contest, Marcus Pott could get very, very badly hurt. It's his third standing count. Oh, come on, referee, stop this fight. Stop this fight. He has now. It's all over, and quite right, too. Quite right. That is a magnificent win for Michael Murray of Manchester. A win that was shamefully delayed, but one that happily was not delayed too long, because I was worried for Marcus Bott there, Barry, in the light of what we've seen in the ring in recent weeks.
He took 20 punches from a super heavyweight, and he shouldn't have taken them. The referee should have. You see, this is where a hometown crowd can sway a referee's decisions. You know, he can affect his professionalism, and he should have stopped that fight a half a minute sooner. He took far too much there.
Well, that ranks as by far and away as the best win of Michael Murray's career against the current heavyweight champion of Germany, the man who is ranked as the number 6 heavyweight in Europe, Marcus Bott. And where does that leave Michael Murray now, I wonder, Barry?
Well, I don't think we should get too excited about it. He fought a man that was 2 stone lighter than him, and you know, these ratings can look false, but it's certainly a superb win for Michael Murray, and it will give him the confidence that he needs to go on and to greater things.
Well, we will get the official announcement from our MC Herr Kruntz.
So, meine Damen und Herren, lassen Sie mich einen Satz, das mögen Sie mir bitte zugestehen, vorweg sagen. Markus, du hast ein fantastisches Publikum hinter dir. Das wird auch so sein und wird so bleiben, auch wenn du diesen Kampf, deinen 16. erstmals nicht gewonnen hast. Du warst tapfer, daran gibt es keinen Zweifel.
Well, I don't know what Herbert saying, but it's going down well enough.
Und hier das Urteil, meine Damen und Herren. Das Kampfgericht entscheidet. Sieger in der 7. Runde nach 1 Minute 45 durch technischen K.O. Michael Murray, Großbritannien.
And good reaction from the crowd. That is nice to see and nice to hear. Some British crowds, please take note.
Athleten und den Ringrichter, den wir hiermit auch verabschieden, für heute einen donnernden Applaus. Das haben sie beide verdient.
And, well,